Hey, yeah. Welcome to another Rust Belt Reaction. I am your absent-minded host, Trip, alongside...
Oh, I guess I'm absent-minded, too. Yeah, I couldn't remember my name. But no, I am Vince, and today we're going to be... it's another one. You know, I'm going to reference my dad again. Yeah, I remember him talking about Eric Carmen when I was a kid. And, you know, I think, what is it? It was like Beachwood? Was Eric Carmen from, like, actually Beachwood?
I think so. I didn't do the research on this one.
Yeah, but Eric Carmen of the Raspberries. Nobody ever pronounces the P, and I'm doing it.
We just had a discussion about this, didn't we?
Wednesday and yes, February.
Yes. What's that quarterback from Green Bay?
Favre. Yeah, I don't know much. I know Eric Carmen went on to have a pretty successful solo career. Mm-hmm. Is it Hungry? Did he do that one or no?
Yeah, I'm not going to pretend to know, man.
I know. Here I start talking and just everyone realizes
I'm just gonna let you
how
roll,
stupid
man.
I am.
Let them beat you up.
Go all the way.
Mm-hmm. And this guy will. I'll tell you at the end of the video.
Yeah. Oh, trust me. I'll go all the way. I'm kind of like Rage the Poetic. I like it with the lights on.
You like it? Still my favorite yet.
Alrighty. All right. Here we go. Little raspberries.
Did guys go to hairdressers back in the 60s and 70s? That's definitely a hairdresser
that
dude
is a,
right there.
Yeah, that is a definitely, it's like definitely a salon. He has his whole head in that thing. You know, that they
looks
put
almost
on.
Like Gilda Radner there.
He does look like Gilda Radner.
Yeah, a little
right
bit
there,
right there.
You know? I think my curly cues.
Yeah, I think my grandmother had that dude back in the day.
Yeah, it's weird. Yeah. But no, didn't we? The Mike Douglas, wasn't there?
Yeah, because this is on the Mike Douglas Show.
Yeah.
That's another Cleveland tie-in, because the Michael Douglas Show, Mike Douglas Show, started here in Cleveland before he moved to, I forgot what other city he moved the show to.
But, Chicago, probably, or something.
Yeah. Well, he's from Chicago.
Oh, is that right?
And he moved to Cleveland, did the show here, and then it moved someplace else. Mm. So, not sure if this performance, this performance might be in Cleveland. So,
okay.
So Mike Douglas... Kiss has been on a lot of people's been on that show.
Mm.
So I think it was Kiss's first TV appearance was on the Mike Douglas show.
Oh, is that right? Yeah. Okay.
And usually, you know, I'm a Kiss fan, so I gotta go into my Kiss thing here. you know, usually when Kiss does interviews, Paul Stanley's the guy that people talk to. Mm. But on the Mike Douglas show, Gene comes on the show and first time on TV and he's in full character.
I heard that's not the only place Gene comes.
I think all the photos were burnt.
No, but yeah.
So, you know, he just came on and he was very awkward because he didn't know how to act. And, you know, they're in their 20s and makeup. And
yeah,
he's just playing this character. But yeah, that might have been in Cleveland too. So it was 1974. So.
Oh, nice. All right. Yeah.
All right. Well, back to Gilda Radner.
Yeah.
All right. That's Eric Carmen. I'm sorry, Eric. You're watching this. We're just bagging on the hair,
hey,
man.
Hey, if Eric Carmen's watching this, I'm going to be impressed.
But you got two bald bastards
yeah,
here.
Yeah, right? Oh. Yeah. We're just hating because of the, yeah.
You know, I'm wearing my Eric Carmen wig. He's
gone away. Just told me, don't ever let me go. So I mean, this song wouldn't fly today. I mean, it's a little date rapey, right?
Well, you know, just a little bit.
You know, I was gonna say like the Billy Joel, like "Come Out, Virginia," whatever, and he's like trying to convince the Catholic girl to like have sex with him, basically. Oh. And it's like very, very. You could say that he's grooming her.
Pushy.
A little pushy. Yeah. A little pushy with the sex.
They were making a big stink about a year or so ago about the baby, it's cold.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
The sensitive fucking pussy world we live in now.
Well, you know, I'll tell you what. There's one that I kind of can get behind is the Pepe Le Pew.
Really?
Well, you know, I remember even as a kid, I'm like, man, this guy is like a rapist.
Well,
I mean, for sure.
Well, yeah, but I don't think that was the what they were getting at, I think.
Like that French lover kind of thing. Well, yeah.
But it's a dumb animal who can't recognize it, what he's trying to get some from as a cat. And I think that was the joke, you know.
Well, yeah, but man, he's like, that cat wants nothing to do with it. And he is just... I mean, it's a little... I mean, obviously, I don't think it should have been canceled or anything like that. But if there's any one of those things, I think that that's one I can... I'm like, okay, if you're going to take one, I'll give you that one.
It's it's understanding the reality versus this is a cartoon comedy, you know.
Yeah.
And comedy and cartoons are exaggerations of, you know.
And those Looney Tunes weren't originally made for children. I mean, they were,
you know, kind of like, you know, Family Guy and Simpsons. Yeah. It's more of an adult base.
Right.
But, you know.
Yeah.
As time goes on and, you know.
All right. Well,
TV channels, you know, they have to fill in space, so you get the cartoons and in front of the kids. But
so, all right, yeah, back to convincing the girl to go all the way. When that song starts, I mean, it does not seem like it's gonna go there.
No.
You know, and even like in the breakdown in the middle, and then there's a few other like bridge parts, it's almost like none of those parts go together, but they do. It's strange.
Well, that's,
you know,
that's the beauty of Carmen, you know, because his vocal just...
It's like a Roy Orbison kind of...
Yeah, definitely Roy Orbison.
Yeah. That operatic kind of thing. But yeah, it's just the song, it's like if you were to play like... I think there's like four different parts that like if you were to play like each one and then you'd play... You were like, if I was in the band and I'm like, yeah, and then we're going to go into this, I'd be like, well, that doesn't why would you do that? But I don't know. For some reason, it works. You know what I mean? It's like the whole sound of it. Like at the beginning, it's like rocking, and then all of a sudden, it goes into this like really Roy Orbison-y kind of, you know, part, and real melodic and smooth, and then it gets grittier, and it's a strange song to me, but it, for some reason, it's really good and it works. It's just, I don't know, it's crazy.
I'm paying attention. I'm just trying to find the right Gilda Radner picture to do a side by side here. In case you don't know, he's playing with his phone. He's not even paying attention.
The Rosanna Dana.
No, that the hair was crazy. I'm trying to find her more reserved haircut. But the face is definitely there.
And maybe I can, or maybe our production team could edit in a here photo there.
Here he is, Eric Carmen.
Yeah. There it is. Yeah, Eric Carmen or Gil. Yeah, you get the point. At least you see the hair.
Yeah.
But yeah, all right. Well, there it was. The Raspberries.
I enjoyed it. It's a classic.
It's a classic.
That's probably their biggest song. You know?
Yeah, I mean, it's that's probably played at least once a day on any oldies station.
Especially here in Cleveland. You know? Amongst their 50 song same rotation that they always do.
Right. And then they, what is it, 105? I don't know if it's like this in every city, but 105.7. They always like add extra this reverb. They always add extra reverb to everything.
I don't know what it is.
Yeah, I don't know. It'll just make it sound old for some reason. I don't know what that. Yeah, but yeah.
I guess hide the compression. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm not a tech head on that shit, but
yeah, I don't know. Hey, if anyone knows why 105.7
does that,
yeah, man. They add all that extra reverb. I don't know.
A lot of reverb recently in this, you know, sets of
it's a pet peeve of mine too. Yeah. You know, like, just come on, man. Like, you can have a tasty amount of reverb, but come on, man.
I mean, me personally, when I use reverb, it's you know, hide my weakness. You know? But yeah, that's not the case with some of these artists that we do.
No.
I don't know what the reason is.
But. Yeah.
But I'm yammering away, so I'm just going to cut it when I'm ahead and say, be sure to like and subscribe and to tell your friends and Pepe Le Pew here.
The you know, the cute one, you know, and make sure she wants to go all the way.
All the way.
Yeah.
Bye.